You deserve this. Well, we're back in Pahrump. Decided to come up here while our motor coach was being worked on by National Indoor RV Center. They're going to have it for about the next 4 days. So, killing time, we decided to come back to Pahrump. There's a quilt shop that Barb wanted to go to. And if you know Barb, she can't pass a quilt shop. So, I'm going to swing around here so you can see behind me. That's the quilt shop. It's actually in somebody's house. That just seems very, very weird. I know Pahrump is a small town, but this is very weird to have a quilt shop in somebody's house. Anyway, she's going to go in there and take a look at it. While we're here, we also drove through a another RV park, and I'll go ahead and show some images of that. The place we stayed when we stayed here, Preferred RV, was a nice park. $10 a night, plus the little resort fee, and it was comfortable. The swimming pool and the jacuzzi were all indoors. Lots of activities, very friendly people. So we went to this other one somebody recommended. We drove through there. Lots of amenities, very, very nice. But you're going to end up paying for that. For a rig our size, it'd be about $50 to $60 per night. Quite a jump in the rate. So if you want the amenities, you're going to get it. They have an outdoor pool there that looks really nice as well, but they don't heat it during the winter time because it would never shut off. I mean, the propane would be running all the time. It's so cold out here. They said about May is when they start running the heat again, May through September. So it'll stay warm then. Right now, it's an iceberg. As I mentioned before, I bought a new wireless microphone, so hopefully it cut out some of the wind noise. The wind's not really blowing right now. I'm not using the wireless mic, but I'm going to give it a test. My dog ate the windscreen off of it, and so we tried to find replacement windscreens. Best Buy, Fry's, Office Max, Office Depot, Target. Walmart, we went to a lot of different stores looking for windscreens. They just don't sell them. I could probably get it off of Amazon, but I'm not going to find it at a regular store. So instead, what I bought were these here. This is a part of a Nerf bullet that goes into the Nerf guns where they shoot these darts. And so what we did is we cut this one down. And it actually fits really nicely right over the top of the microphone. It's got the little orange tip on it, which is kind of annoying. We tried to color it, but then with a Sharpie, but then the color just came right off. So I'm going to put this on and give this a try and see if it actually helps with the wind noise. Hang on just a second. Let's do a test. Okay, I've got this microphone hooked up to my collar. You can see it's right here. So you can see that nice, beautiful orange tip there. And I'm hoping that the sound is going to be okay. It's not really that windy right this second. But if you hang on a second, maybe even see the flags behind me. They're just not really moving that much just yet. So I hope the sound is going to be better with this dart, Nerf dart on it. I'm going to start using this a little more often. What I'm not using now that I will be using in the future is a handheld image stabilizer. I have the Osmo by DJI. I've tried it out, and so far I'm not very impressed with it. It's still shaky. I don't know how it's even better than just a regular selfie stick. It's supposed to keep my image stable. It has some functionality with buttons on it, but the buttons don't work. They say you have to download third-party apps to make the buttons work, but they don't tell you which apps to download or what kind of app to download, and so it's really not helpful at all. And so it does some stabilization as far as moving the stick from right to left, but when I'm walking, and you can see even walking with just my handheld selfie stick, this is a little bit bouncy. And when I tried it with the Osmo, it was pretty much the same thing. And so I'm really disappointed in the product. I'll do a more full product review when I have that device up and running. and so you could really get a good feel for it. As of right now, I can't recommend it. That may change as I figure out what apps to use on it and how those apps interface with the actual device. So we'll see how that works out. So really, it's just a matter of preference. Would you like to stay in a campground that has paved slots, all concrete, or would you rather stay in the spot like this, where you have some trees, a little bit of privacy, and but it's all dirt? So there's no right answer. It's just a matter of preference. I prefer this kind of spot over the other spot. On our way back to Vegas, we decided we'd stop by this place. We saw a sign said they're world famous. So I don't know what they're world famous for, but we're going to find out. And when we got here, we found snow. And so there's Barb over there trying to make a snowman. I don't think there's enough for that, but we'll see how it looks when she's done. Here is her snow queen. Even has a diamond tiara on top. And you can see that she put a lot of work into this as she walks over next to it. You can actually see how big it is. So there you go, a snow queen in the snow in Nevada. Well, here's the pathway up to where we're going. It says Eaton Shop here. Oh look, money. Good thing they have bars up. So we're gonna walk up here. We have to stay on the snowy part, otherwise you'll pretty much fall and slip on your ass. Now it smells really good in here. It smells like barbecue. A couple little shops up here. Here's a gift shop. Oh, almost fell. Gift shop.
Ooh, the barbecue smells.
Oh, there's the barbecue place right there. But we're gonna go into the gift shop. I think this is where they cook. But they also have dollar bills up here on the wall. Looks like people have signed their dollar bills, but we're not allowed in there. So we're gonna go back down here, which is where the saloon is. Not just any saloon, the world famous saloon. Well, there's a stage here. More money on the wall. And some shuffleboard. Cool.
First time I went to the mine.
Get more in all our bills.
Do you guys want menu?
All fine. Everywhere you look. Still no either world famous. So I asked, what makes this place world famous? And the answer was kind of a blank stare, and then it's been here since 1953, so it's certainly been here a while. Now Barb ordered a pulled pork sandwich from the barbecue place because the smell is just outstanding, so we'll take a look at how that looks when we're served. But I think we have to go back up to the restaurant to actually get it. I'm not sure yet. So I'm going to enjoy a beer and hang out in the Dollar Bar. Yeah, some people write really interesting things on their dollar bills. Boo! Boo!
Taxation is bad.
Yeah. One thing it shows here is there's a lot of Harley stuff here, so I think this is a pretty popular biker pull-off area on the right between Pahrump and Vegas. Our fruit came, and here is the pulled pork sandwich that we got. It's on a hoagie roll, and there you go. Looks like pulled pork, fries. Bon appetit. It is a cute little place. It looks like a comfortable place to drink and eat. And a lot more crowded than I thought it would be out here in the middle of nowhere. Well, today we decided to drive down to Laughlin just to spend a day on the road. It's a beautiful drive down here. While they still have our coach in the shop, we're just killing time. So behind me you can see there's a casino back there. And then I'm going to spin around this way. And you can see this one here looks like a giant steamship. Or a paddle boat, I mean. So, we're just going to walk around in there. I don't think they like it when you film inside their casinos, so we won't be doing any of that. Actually, all of Laughlin is just a very small strip here. There isn't a lot to it. Four or five hotels. I can see a Golden Nugget from here. Harrah's, you know, a couple of the big name casinos here. And that's about it. Just a little town in the middle of the desert. Where they bring people in to do gambling. At the Claim Jumper restaurant, we won enough money for lunch on Lucky the Larry the Lobster. Without coming to Herbert Hoover Dam. So here we are at the dam. We've now parked in the dam parking lot. We're going to go up to the dam visitor center and take a dam tour. Looks like a new Disney water ride. Whoa! Looks like a pretty wicked skateboard park. I know, you gotta say it, otherwise somebody would put their kid there, right? On this side of the road over here, it's 12 noon. But over here, on this side of the road, 1 o'clock, Arizona, and then this over here, Nevada. That is a long way down there. standing in line waiting for a tour, about half an hour wait for a 24-minute tour. So I guess we're going to do it anyway. This is going to be a tour of the spillway, I think. Actually, I don't know what line I'm standing in, but everybody else is here, so this is where I'm standing. We have a really nice view while we stand here and wait. It is cold. The wind is blowing, which makes it even colder. I'm all this way, and the dam tour is not available. However, the power plant tour is, so that's what we're standing in line for. And then we'll probably go into the visitor center if we still have time. Okay, here we are, 530 feet below ground, headed over to the Nevada side of the dam.
If you look just past that, you see the really strange looking torture device down there? That's our pelting water wheel. We have two of them. Same thing that only comes out about once every 20 years. Being we only have two, there's a good chance I'll probably never see one of these come out again. So it's a guess, it's something pretty rare. Alright, on behalf.
There you go, there's a highest paid job, shovel operator at $1.25 an hour. One dam equals 18 Empire State Buildings.
0.5 inch diameter cables. If you follow the cable to the ramps below.
These are angled out to make sure that those wires don't touch the sides of the canyon and short out, and so they have to be cantilevered at that angle.
Courage and skill.
Looks like they're going to fall over.
Perform some of the most dangerous undertakings on the boulder.
And that crane right there, and there's a blackish cable that you can see running through there. That is from the original building of this dam and how they delivered materials to the other side.
Future is limitless. That we have in our grasp the power to
all the pictures you wish. The next presentation is located across the street at the flagpole.
You can tell by looking at this, a few people have touched the toes.
At the top of the flagpole, 142 feet above the sculpture, you see.
It'd be pretty impressive if the whole thing was cleaned. These are the spillways where water enters into the area where the turbines are then spun with the water that's entering.
Those fish are huge. I can see them, and there's more right there.
The white rock you see here is the high water mark, which was hit in the early 80s. This area floods and droughts quite often. So right now, the low water mark is 14 feet below what we see here. So it can fluctuate greatly. They're just waiting for the next big flood to then turn these turbines. And it looks like from that high water mark, you're really not too far from the top of the dam. I'm zoomed in here on one of the turbines just to show you can see the watermarks here on the concrete for the high water mark. And then that gives you an idea how close it was to the top of the dam. It looks like just a couple of feet more, and it's hitting the top of the dam.
Well, we're going to finish off our dam day here at the Texas Roadhouse. I want to thank Art and Christy for providing gift certificates to this place. It's Valentine's Day, so I'm going to treat Barb to a nice steak dinner, and I get off the hook pretty cheap. I might also have a beer or two, maybe, while I'm here. So thanks again, Christy and Art. We're going to go in here and see what it's all about. It's not open quite yet, but they should be opening shortly, and we're going to go ahead and head inside.
Thank you.
here is the inside of the National Indoor RV Center facilities. They have not been authorized to occupy this part of the building yet because of permitting and getting all the wiring and stuff done. So the only part of the building they can occupy right now is over here. Everything to the right of the picture here is what's in storage. And then everything over here to the left is their service area. So these are all the coaches that they're working on right now. And my coach is right over there. So they're still working on that. What's odd about this facility is it's really a warehouse and set up to be a warehouse. And you can see you have these great big bay doors here with a ramp that leads down into the lower parking area. But all the rest of these doors are set high enough up for like deliveries. And so you can't just drive a coach directly in here. You have to bring them up the ramp in here and then bring them in here into the bays to be worked on. So it's a little more difficult. I think they need to do some adjustments with these bay doors here because it is kind of tight bringing the coach in. But they have what they call a valet service, and those are the people that will drive your coach in and out for you, so you don't actually have to do it, which is great because if they hit something or, you know, make a mistake, then it's on them. So I'm going to go and check in on my coach. Well, today is a travel day, I hope. We had to order some parts. They're not here yet. We're supposed to be on our way to Parker today. We tried to leave last night, and we got about 4 miles down the road in a rainstorm, and my windshield wiper stopped working. And so now there's a control module and a motor that needs to be replaced. They can't find the motor, but they found a control module, so they're going to get that in today. At least that'll get me down the road. And then I'm going to have to come back to get some of the other warranty work done. I came in with a list of about, I'd say 15 items. And we got maybe 10 of those done, which is a little bit better than I expected. There's other items that can be fixed. We just have to wait for parts to show up. So, we'll be back. Well, we made it to Parker. This place is not as big of a dump as I was led to believe it was. It's actually pretty nice here as far as being right here on the river. There are not a lot of amenities in this park. They used to have a swimming pool, but they filled that in. They used to have a laundry room, but all the machines are broken. They used to have bathrooms, now they have outhouses. So, you know, that part of it isn't great. However, there are a lot of long-term residents here. There are some people who stay here year-round, and then there's other people who just come down for the snowbird season. They do have a lot of activities here. So in the next video, I'm going to go ahead and talk about those some more, do a more in-depth review of this park, talk about some of the activities that we're engaged in, and just have a general good time here. So I'll go ahead and call this video here, and we'll see you soon in the next video from Parker, Arizona. I hear that there is something going on here in the clubhouse, so I'm going to take a peek and see what's happening in here. Hey, what's going on in here?
I'm eating cake. I'm taking swimming lessons.
I think you guys aren't telling the truth.
I don't know.
How can you tell?
Which is the chapter around my mouth? Anything you say to him is going on a video, lady. So if you don't want to be on video, put fabric in front of your face.
Yeah. Okay, good morning. That's all we're saying.
There you go.
Good morning.
Good morning.
This sign clearly says man cave. Where are the men?
Kicked them out.
Okay.
Be nervous.